Hey guys, it's Andrew Escavel here, back with another tutorial, and today I'm going to show you how to block a website from being accessed on your network using your ZyXEL Zywall USG 20. Now, to do this is a fairly simple process. First, we'll head over to our configuration tab. From there, we're going to navigate over to Anti-X and expand that and bring us down to Content Filter. That'll bring you to this page right here. Now let's explain a few things. This first checkbox up here called Enable Content Filter is more or less your on-off switch for everything we're about to do. We're going to leave it off for right now because we have to configure a few things first. So let's go over to Filter Profile, where we will create the profile. Here we click Add, and it'll bring us to this. Now, we're not going to pay for services like ComTouch or Bluecoat, so let's go over to Custom Service. We have to give it a name, so let's call it block_eBay. Now, you can't have spaces in the name, otherwise it'll be an invalid name. So, next we click on Enable Custom Service. Now, also make sure you have checked the Check Common Trusted Forbidden List, which will be these tabs up here at the top we'll work in just a second. Now keep in mind, what we're about to do, you can more or less do from this page right here, using the Trusted Websites Add button, or Forbidden Websites Add button, or block things based on the keywords. But for the way I like to do it, we're going to just have this the way it is and click OK. And now we have our profile. Next, because we are going to block a website, we'll click on Forbidden Websites. From here, we just enter the URL of the website, which will be www.ebay.com. And then we hit enter while we're still in this menu, and voila. Notice this little red triangle in the corner here. Unless you click apply, it's not actually set in stone. So now that we clicked apply, the little red button's gone. And now we can go back over to general. Now, policies. We need to add one. To do so, we click on the add button. And we're going to make sure that this is checked to enable said policy. Now, if you want this to affect the entire network, have the addresses as any and the user groups as any. If you want this to go off only during certain hours of the day, you need to make a schedule first and then select the schedule in this drop-down menu. But because we just want to show how to do this in general, we're going to leave everything as is and make sure the filter profile is the one that we just made. So in your drop-down menu, you should see it. If you have multiple profiles, select the one you want and click OK. So now that you can see that we have the little light bulb that's turned on, it means that profile is active, but we have not yet enabled the filtering. Now we can click on Enable Content Filter, and then down here, click Apply. So now, eBay should be blocked. Okay, so let's give it a go. www.ebay.com. And there you go. This is the page you'll see when the website is successfully blocked. And now you know how to block a website. Keep in mind, certain websites that use HTTPS by default might not be as easy to block. Now, what you can do is, in place of the website name, use the website's IP address instead, and you should be able to block it that way. If not, you may have to explore other options. So, thanks for watching. Don't forget to comment, rate, subscribe, show your friends, check out my other videos. I got plenty of them. And I'll see you next time.